In this video, I'll share my whole experience crossing the Grand Canyon in one day from beginning to end. I recorded a lot of updates as I was making my way across, about 25 miles across with a lot of elevation loss and a lot of elevation gain, like a reverse mountain climb. I knew I could make it across the Grand Canyon, but the question was, how much would I suffer? I trained, but it's hard to know how much is enough. I thought a lot about water, about my feet, about the sun, nutrition, fuel.
We got up a little before 2 a.m. and we tried to figure out the coffee machine.
There's a light. I'm gonna pass you one more.
This was the first day the trail from the North Rim would be open for the season, and we wanted to get an early start, so we had plenty of time to make it across before dark. Things started off a little weird with Google sending us down a narrow dirt road that ended in a closed gate.
That was the first, but not the last closed gate we came to. They said it was gonna be open at 12:01, so we've been waiting here a while.
Morning.
Morning.
Finally, just before 6 a.m., we were in.
Welcome on opening day.
Yay.
Thank you.
You're welcome. So do you guys have a pass?
It's about 6:45 a.m. We are on the North Rim Trail, North Kebab Trail. That's where we are. It's been a hell of a morning. We have been through so many roadblocks.
Before we even started, as we were heading up to the entry point on the North Rim, one of the members of our group started to feel altitude sickness. It's something you might not realize, but the North Rim is at a fairly high elevation. She and her husband were ready to go, and they figured the faster they got moving, the sooner they would get to a lower elevation.
So we finally got going, and now this is freaking amazing. I mean, we haven't even gone a mile. I've stopped a lot to take pictures, but this is just like, the whole thing is worth it right now. Oh my God, look at that. This really feels like a dream come true. It is just so cool to be walking in the Grand Canyon like this. I'm just so excited about it. And note to self, I need to put sunblock, not just on all the places that I usually forget, you know, like ears, but side of neck and backs of hands. This is for you, Mom, so you can see. I'm working hard not to get sunburned, and I do have sunblock on too. I think I'm about 3 miles in, and my knees were hurting a little bit on the downhills. I think we're about halfway through. I think it's like 6 miles downhill, but I found if I kind of trot, it's a little easier on my knees.
I had a map and a tracker on my phone, but I started it late, so I was never sure exactly how many miles I'd gone.
So I just checked, and it looks like we've only gone like 4 or 5 miles in 2 hours, so I think we have to go a little faster.
My biggest worries were the heat and finishing before it got too dark. After the descent, there was a section with no shade, and the sun started to feel really hot.
Just crossed that little stream, and I wet that blue rag, and then I dunked my hat, and it feels great. So far, so good. I would say I'm about 9 miles in. This is the hot, dry part. I passed a stream maybe 2 miles ago and got my hat all wet, and it felt great. But now it's super dry and hot, so I'm trying to get through the hot part quickly, but also like stopping if I need to when there's a tiny spot of shaded. It's kind of weird, I've been on my own for a while, for really the last 3 or 4 miles. I have 2 more miles, about 2.5 miles to get to Phantom Ranch, but I just want to keep going through this hot section and get out of the sun. And there's 2 people way out ahead of me. Thought I might catch them, but I haven't. And then everybody else is way behind. I mean, at some moments it's really peaceful and I just am grinning ear to ear because I can't believe I'm here. And then every now and then it's a little weird to be, you know, so far from the rest of my group and not having seen them in a while.
In the first real stretch of shade, I caught up with Tracy and Bruce, the couple that had sped ahead to get to the lower altitudes. She was happy to have a little distraction. She still wasn't feeling well, and I was really happy to have company. The 3 of us walked together to Phantom Ranch. We celebrated when we arrived. She took a long nap. I took my shoes off. I had an ice cold iced tea. We waited there for an hour, hoping the rest of the group would show up. But we finally decided we needed to head out and get going.
We just left Phantom Ranch and we made it to the Colorado, which is pretty exciting.
Woohoo!
Woohoo! And we have about 9 miles left, but here we go crossing the bridge. And we all feel pretty refreshed, right? From a little stop, some iced coffee, and iced tea, and lemonade, and ice. A little nap, a little time with shoes off.
Back of my mind, though, I kept thinking about something Johnny had said the day before. 99% is only halfway done, and we were nowhere near 99%. The terrain and the views were different on the other side as we started to climb. Then the wind suddenly kicked up. A storm was rolling in. That was super unexpected, but my East Coast instincts kicked in. I stopped to make sure my down puffy sweater and my headlamp were sealed in waterproof bags. As it turned out, it was just a drizzle, but it was so welcome and it kept us cool.
So we have about four or five miles left, but I keep thinking we're near the top, but then you look at this. We have to get up there. That was you. But we're almost out, so too late. If only we'd seen that beforehand.
Yeah, if we'd known before, we would have been prepared.
Looking back at where we'd come from was such an amazing feeling. Seeing the distance we'd covered and the spectacular views.
When we were way down there, we were looking at that going, that's our finish line. And it was all of that back then.
It seemed like a long ways off.
We have come a long freaking way.
Yeah, we have.
But we were a lot further from the top than we thought at the time.
The good news is, it's not too hot, and everybody's accounted for, and Andrea's waiting at the top. The bad news is, we thought we were a mile from the top. It turns out we're 3 miles from the top.
Boo!
Boo!
Boo-boo.
The other good news is that we just had a handful of Fritos and some of us had some Sour Patch Kids, and I think that put a little spring in my step. Look at that. Now, is that the trail we took? That one wiggling through the valley? Yeah.
By then, our cell service had kicked back in, and we heard that the rest of the group was fine. They were spending the night at Phantom Ranch. Through some miracle, a room opened up in the cabins there, and they would hike out the final 9 miles the next morning.
It's unbelievable, the view. Just unbelievable.
At every single switchback, I was just stunned by the views. 10 or 15 minutes from the top, it got dark enough to need our headlamps. We did that final little bit in the dark. Just a few minutes from the top, we were welcomed by Andrea. What a joy.
Oh, it's so nice
to
see you.
Gosh, you guys are amazing.
Oh.
We did it!
You guys are amazing. Woohoo! I love it.
Yes, we did it. And we are so freaking happy.
What are my final thoughts on the experience? Well, of course, it was amazing. But in a lot of ways, walking across the Grand Canyon in one day is easier than a lot of things we do in our lives. Just showing up for work all day, every day, sitting in front of a computer day after day, commuting, you know, taking care of toddlers, all those things that many of us take for granted. I think a lot of those are harder than walking across the Grand Canyon. The Grand Canyon was spectacular. It was beautiful. It felt to me like it was really an honor to get to experience that. And it really reminded me that this is something I need to do more of. And so I'm saying it out loud. It's my full intention to have more of these great outdoor experiences and make more of these videos.